the way the women's tour sees her now is the most consistent performer by far.
Yep.
She is the player right now that, yes, she doesn't have, for example, when Serena was dominant, the ability to blow an opponent off the court like Serena can.
Mm.
But her consistency of performance is so far ahead of the rest of the field, especially with what Naomi Osaka is going through at the moment. She probably is a long way off her best tennis.
Absolutely.
Because of all the other distraction that, yeah, you know, for whatever reason, obviously we know about the mental health struggles, and you know, maybe she could have handled it a little bit differently and maybe not brought such attention to the situation. But
yep,
the way the tour is playing out right now, Ash is by far the favourite on the women's side, and the rest of the draw knows it. But it also puts a level of pressure on Ash Barty as she comes into this event.
It does. And I think I've said a few times in the last couple of weeks, Grothy, I think this is no doubt her best opportunity with her own form, what's going on around her, 40 match wins this year, 5 titles, Wimbledon winner. She's won on different surfaces. Her and her team have been away, but they're a great team, aren't they? Craig Tizer and Mel, the physio, who's with a lot of the Aussie players. And then, you know, Gary, her partner's joined her for the extended part now of the trip. And now we learn, what, over the weekend, the Billie Jean King Cup's going to be on later in the year in November. So who knows when she's going to be back. So it's a long stretch. She loves family and those close to her. Her manager's based in Australia, Nikki. So they're doing a mighty job. But it's that team around her. And that, to put the value on that is probably really hard to measure it totally. But it's got to be worth a hell of a lot.
Yeah, and she always speaks of the we. And I think it helps her sort of handle some of that pressure, almost dilutes it a little bit amongst the team. But in the end, she's the one that's got to go out and perform. And I know you're across the draw as well, but as I look through what she's got to get through, I think, you know, in the fourth round is where, for me, or the quarters, there's a few names in there when you look through that you start to maybe think. You know, Jennifer Brady, obviously, for me, is a great hardcore player and playing at home. And then you put in there also Belinda Bencic, the number 11 seed in New York, who comes off, you know, an incredible run at the Olympics. You know, for Ash, I don't know. When I look through the draw, I don't see a lot of names, especially on her side of the draw, that I think are huge threats.
And when you hear that stuff there, that, and talk about consistency on the court, there's consistency in the message every time she steps up to a microphone. Before she opens her mouth, Grothy, you know what she's going to basically trot out.
Yep.
And it comes down to the E word, and that's execution. Because she internally, no doubt, is pretty confident about what she's doing out there. And maybe Wimbledon's given her some real validation. I'm not just a one slam wonder. I've now won two. Who knows what I can go on to achieve here. But tennis players can, sports people can have an off day.
Well, and that's the thing.
Tokyo, she had an off day.
Yeah, and that's probably the only, I literally wrote here, when we're going to talk about it, I don't believe that anyone can challenge her. It would take her having quite an off day.
Yeah.
That's how I would sum up how Ash, unless you get someone like an Osaka comes out and has an absolute ball striking day, maybe a Sabalenka has an absolute ball striking day, but in terms of consistency of performance, but I guess it is that, isn't it? It's a one-on-one battle on the day. So maybe someone has a day out or she has an off day, but otherwise her performance is so good right now.
It is. I mean, the serve is brilliant. The forehand, we always talk about the slice backhand. I mean, just every part of it, and her ability to reset and strategically think her way through, her IQ out there. I mean, she can get herself out of trouble. She said, I don't know if that was part of that grab there, but you know, she goes to the toolbox, as she refers to, pull out a few things that she might need.